We are very blessed to be able to experience God's love in Christ Jesus, His beloved Son. And we accompany the Magi and the shepherds and Mary and Joseph to the birth of Christ. And it is the mystery that we celebrate, and a mystery not only in the past, but also present with us today. May God bless you.
Long before the birth of Jesus, prophets foretold of the wonderful event, the coming of a Prince of Peace who would be a Son of God and would bring hope to all the world.
The people who walked in the darkness have seen a great light, for a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice, with righteousness from the time and forevermore.
Many years passed before the words of the prophets were fulfilled.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply echo back their joyous strains. Go,
to a simple maiden in the town of Nazareth came the greatest honor and glory yet bestowed upon a woman. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said,
"Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you."
She was much perplexed by his words, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be.
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. You will name him Jesus. The Holy Spirit will be upon you, and the power of Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the baby to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, will also conceive a son, who with the sixth month she was said to be barren, for nothing is impossible with God."
"Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word."
The angel departed from her.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how
Christmas over 2,000 years ago was a seemingly unimportant event, the birth of a child in a lowly manger in Bethlehem.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered, and all went to their own towns to be enrolled. And Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. There was no place for them in the inn in Bethlehem.
And so it was that she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger.
Christ child were some humble shepherds in the hills near Bethlehem. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid, for behold, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of this heavenly host, praising God and saying,
"Glory to the God in the highest heaven,
and in earth peace among those whom he favors."
When the angels left, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has been made known to us."
So they left quickly and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
Poor shepherds were not the only worshippers at the grove at Bethlehem. Strange visitors also came bearing fine gifts. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking,
"Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observe his star at this rising and have come to pay him homage."
When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I might also go and pay him homage. The king sent out with the star ahead of them. Finally, the star stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. They knew before the holy family and offered them gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The kings were the warned in a dream to not return to Herod, and they left for their own country by another road.
Hello again, and first of all, I just wanted to show a gratitude to all the families and who have helped to put this virtual Christmas pageant together. And as we reflect upon the mystery of Christmas, and we see how the Magi and the shepherds and they all, after witnessing this miracle birth of God becoming human, that they went away with awe and glory and wonder in our hearts and with gratitude in their hearts. And may we also do that as well. So once again, wishing you a wonderful and blessed Christmas season.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing.
Okay, and action, go.
Is it prophets?
Prophets, say prophets.
Prophets.
Okay, ready, and action, go.
Long before the birth of Jesus, prophets foretold of a wonderful event, the coming of a prince of peace who would be a son of God and would bring hope to all the world.
Cut.